Alrighty. Got some caffeine in me. It's a good start to the morning. It's bright and sunny out. Thought today would be a good day to go drone fishing. Hey! I didn't ask you to talk. Don't interrupt. Sorry. It's a little chunky sometimes. Okay. So, drone fishing. What it is you take your drone. I have a DJI Phantom 3 4K. Essentially what you do is you attach fishing line to it, send it to 300-400 feet, however far you want out in the ocean. You drop the line, and that line is attached to a fishing pole, and you catch a fish. Pretty cool, right? Didn't know how to do it, but then I looked all over YouTube to see if there was like a tutorial on how to make your drone compatible for drone fishing, how to even start the drone fishing, and there wasn't one. There was just videos of people doing it. So this video will be solely dedicated on how to set up your drone for drone fishing or whatever type of fishing you're going to do. It doesn't have to be in the ocean. That's what I'm doing. You can be in a lake, pond, whatever you desire. So to start out, what you're gonna need is a hanger. Now this is one of those like soft hangers. I don't know if you can see it. It's got like that soft material on it. It's like the nice one, you know. Yeah, cool, I got a nice hanger. So what you're gonna do, essentially this is how it's gonna work. You're gonna take your hanger, drone is attached to the hanger, and the fishing line is going to be attached as hook. But now when the drone goes out, we can't just attach it to the hook like this. We're gonna have to do some modifications to the hanger, not to the drone. Don't want to mess that up. Okay, so what we're gonna do is, this is a hook like this currently. What we're gonna want to do is make the hook so it looks like you're going on a U-turn in a car. I really know how to I don't know, I'll put like a picture or something like here, there, or there on what it's supposed to look like, but might as well just get into it. So what I'm going to be using is a pair of pliers. I don't know, these are the Fat Max, I don't really know if that matters. Some needle nose pliers, makes it a little bit easier, as well as some aluminum cutters. Now these are meant for aluminum sheets, but it'll work on anything. It doesn't have to be aluminum, you know, breaking the system. Anyways, alright, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this hanger and we're just gonna start. First of all, we're gonna cut this little end off, because no one likes little things. Alright, if I can get this to. Alright, there we go, that's done. Okay, now that little knobby endy thing is off. And what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to start bending this out straight. The goal is eventually to make it curved, but we're going to want to start it out straight. So, let's get this done. Get some pliers there. Yeah, that's pretty straight. I don't know if you guys can see that. It was that curve, but now we got it straight. Not exactly perfectly straight, in my opinion, but it'll do. Alright, so next, we're gonna wanna turn this so this top end is curved over this way. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the pliers. Now, these are these fat ones. They're probably about a half inch wide, maybe a little bit more than that. I'm gonna go about halfway into the hanger and I'm going to bend towards me. So I'm gonna be going this way. Okay, not bad. So that's how we are now. There we go. Started off with that half circle. Now we got it like that. So as you guys will see in a minute, I already did this. I already made the line in which attaches to this. So essentially this is what's going to happen. You got your hanger. You got your drone. Drone's out in the ocean. And this little piece of paracord that I used, this is going to be attaching to the hanger like this. There you go, not coming out, as you can see. Yeah, oh well, that came out, but I'll explain why later. So it's like this, drone goes out, Once you get to your desired position, what you're going to do is you're going to turn the drone 360 degrees. So rather than pointing out in the direction that you flew out in, you're going to point it back towards you like this. It's kind of an awkward position, but you're going to point it out. It's going to be like this. And then you're going to reverse the drone. This is going to fall off and your line is now going to be in the ocean roaming free. So, there we go. That's done. Let's get to this part. Wow, I am wired up some caffeine right now. Alright. Okay, alright, so that's done. So now what we're going to want to do is figure out a way, the best way to attach this small little, probably 12 inch hanger to the drone. Now we want to maximize and minimize the drag as much as possible. So, here, I'm going to zoom in on this real quick, that way you guys can see it better. Now you guys can see a little bit better. Here you got the drone, the hanger. So what we're gonna need is some zip ties, maybe some rope. And I'm sure you can like drill through your drone, but I literally got this like 2-3 days ago. And I'm already freaking out that I'm flying it over the ocean, so I'd rather not drill into it. So what I'm gonna be using zip ties. I'm gonna be using 4 of these. Now, so these zip ties, these are pretty strong zip ties. I mean, they're not definitely not weak. You can see the difference. This is what, like the zip tie you get at the grocery store for like closing your avocado bag. And then this is like the zip tie for big boys. You know, the ones that have taken off their Huggies. All right, so this is on here. And what essentially we're gonna do is we're gonna attach 4 of these zip ties to each side of the landing gear. And 2 of these zip ties to each side of the landing gear, which will then attach the drone. But one thing we want to be careful of is we still want to have free positioning on this drone and on the camera, the gimbal. We still want to be able to look down, look up, look sideways, look backwards, whichever way we want to look up and look at. So what we're going to do is we're going to, here, there's actually a hole in this hanger right here. And we're going to want to maximize the hole right there. That way the gimbal can freely move into that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it right about there. Let's take off this mount. Now if we move the camera, you can see that we still have full positioning. And one thing we want to make sure with is that when the drone is up in the air, we're not going to be able to see the string from 200-400 feet away. So you're going to want to make sure this camera right here is in perfect line with the end of this hook, because that's what's going to be attached with your fishing line. So as we can see, I mean, it's not perfect, but that'll do. So we're going to want to attach it right here. So let's put this back on just for safety measures. All right, that's back on. So I'm going to take some scissors real quick. I'm going to mark where we're putting it on the drone. There, 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 and there. No, you don't have to use scissors. I just use scissors because I'm too lazy to go inside and get a Sharpie or another marking device. Okay, so now we're gonna take the zip tie. I'm gonna slide it underneath and across. There, I don't really know if you guys can see that, so I'm gonna show you. So what I did is I put it, let's see. So do you guys see how I did that? So there's, that's the hanger, whoop, that's the hanger, landing gear zip tie. And what we're gonna wanna do is attach that zip tie. Hanger, attached drone with zip ties. There you go. Kind of show you what the bottom view looks like. Should look something like this. I don't know if the camera's in focus. Really hoping it is. There we go. Show you the top view. There we go. Alright, so, as you can tell, I mean, it's on there pretty well. It's not coming off at all. Like, I can't even budge it. So, now what we're going to want to do is, before we send our $1,000 drone out into the water and hopefully not crash it, hopefully, I think it'd be a good idea to test it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go grab the battery, my remote, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to send it up for a bit, not long, 5-10 minutes, and just do some maneuvers with it, see how it affects my flying, as well as make sure that I can clearly see the end of this hook with the camera. So, with the gimbal, my bad. So with that being said, I'm going to go get the camera and the battery and reposition you guys out onto the street. Got my propellers, my battery, my charger, the paracord we made earlier, and my iPad. So I'm going to set it up real quick, and then I'm going to attempt to show you guys the flight. I don't really have a cameraman right now, or anyone that wants to help me make this video, so that's kind of depressing. But you know what, fuck it, we're going to do it anyways. Alright, first thing we're going to do, I might time lapse this, I might not. I've been rolling on the freeway, I've been riding 85. I've been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got millions on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe. I've been rolling on the freeway, I've been riding 85. I've been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got millions on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe.
Hell of you on my right leg, that's Gucci. Dig what I'm saying. Hell of you on my main hole, that's Poochie. Dig what I'm saying. Caught a little jet lag, but I'm golden. Yeah. We deserve Grammys and some Oscars. They deserve Whammies, they imposters. I be rolling with my project homies. It's a vibe. I just did some feels with the homie. It's a vibe.
Okay, so the drone is warmed up. I put the batteries in, the propellers on, taking off my gimbal, got my iPad and the drone. So what we're going to do is we're going to send it up. Alright. Not really sure whether or not you guys can hear me at the moment. So we got the drone, here we go. So now we got the string attached to the drone, so I'm basically going to show you guys how it works. So our string's attached, I'm just going to do some quick tests to make sure that it's not going to fall off. We'll be right back. So, I don't know if you guys can see, this is going to be the test to make sure that the gimbal can move freely. Alright, so now that we got the drone all set up, we're at 82%. I don't want to go lower than 70 because I have to recharge it. But right now I'm just going to send it up. I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see, but I'm just going to do some quick long range tests. So, I don't know if you guys can see that or not. Probably not, because fucking, alright. I don't know if you guys can see it, but that tiny little dot right there is the drone. And it seems to be holding up pretty well. I mean, it's not doing half bad in trying to stay stable. Let's see if I can. There we go. So, I am currently 38 meters in the air. I've been recording this whole video on the Phantom as well, so I'll probably put a little like sidebar. And as you can see right here, is what I'm doing is I'm just moving back and forth, left and right, up and down, and this is to make sure that the string and the hanger aren't going to get caught in the propellers and that the drone still has the capability to stay flying. So I'll show you guys the video in another on the little sidebar. Here we go. Alright, so everything seems to be working pretty good. So I'm gonna stop the video. Or actually, no, I'm gonna keep going the video and show you guys what the landing is like, because I'm sure that the the Phantom is going to get mad because the string is on it when it's landing. So let's see how that's gonna work out. I'm gonna try to land it like right there. Alright. Not half bad. Drone is safely on the air, and on the ground. So I say that test little thingy that we did, that was pretty much of a success. Not too bad. What I actually found is that this little hanger thing that we put on here, this was actually, I'm sure I'm not in focus, my bad, but this little hanger thing on here, it actually helped it land a little bit, because when I was landing, rather than the drone shaking side to side, this hanger really helped it stay stable. So I guess that's a good thing, but I don't know, but okay. All right, so the drone is now, let's see if I can get myself to focus. now that we've done the test, we've made the rope, gotten the string, all we have to do at this point is attach this to the fishing line and then we're ready. And I just called my friend, he said that he would be here fairly shortly, but you know, he's a dumb shit, so I don't know how long, it could be 2 days or that he never shows up, I don't know. Either way, I'm going to try out and go and do this today and look forward to seeing what's happening. I'm sure I'll bring you guys along.
But I really hope it's focused, you know?
Isn't it auto-focus?
Oh, big move. Big move. All right, so we just went to the first jig stop travel place to go rent some poles. And
the guy fucking retired.
Yeah, what the fuck is that?
Oh, am I not allowed to cuss in this?
Yeah, probably shouldn't cuss. And, you know, that's probably bad, you know, because kids. Okay. Anyways, all right, so we went to this place called Jig Stop in Dana Point. You're going left.
I can go left here.
All right, then you're going right. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. All right, so yeah, we were there. We went to Jig Stop. It's actually right here. Show you guys. Right there, Jig Stop Travel. But that motherfucker's closed now. Turn right
onto Golden Lane. Shut up. Then
turn right on. All right, so now we're going to another place. You got to make a U-turn. So we're going to
it's
another place
wide.
Down in Dana Point, and we're gonna try to get some poles. So what we need is an ocean pole. We need some bait, tackle, and that's it, right?
Did you say line? Fishing line?
Oh, well, line. And that comes with the pole, right?
Yeah, most of the time it does.
All right, so there we go. So, that's cool. So, we're going to go there now. All right, so, that's a Tesla. Okay, so we went to another store called West Marine. Totally thought they would have poles, didn't end up having anything. Like literally nothing. So now we're going to a place called Hogan's down by Jack's Surf Shop in Laguna Beach. This chick in there told us that supposedly they have poles, reels, and hooks and everything that we need. So when we get there and if we get the stuff, I'll show you guys what we got.
Hey, we're at Salt Creek Beach now. This is Rowdie, the friend I was talking about earlier. So we went to the fishing store, that place called Hogan's. We got some squid. Now this is natural squid strips, and hopefully the drone will be able to carry this up. We got barrel swivel, don't really know what that is. That's fucked up, all right. Fishing hooks, these are some pretty big hooks. These are...
for big ass fish.
Yeah, for big ass fish. No, that's all shit. Dumbass, all right.
Maybe I can fish out like
We have half inch, 8 fishing weights, or half ounce, I don't know. And then we got some more barrel swivels. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna set up the pole right now. We're gonna set up the pole right now, and then we'll get back to you guys in a minute.
Okay.
Make sure it's recording.
Yeah.
If I stand here, am I in focus?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm gonna send up the drone. You're going to unrelease the reel. I'm gonna put the line on the drone and then just start hauling ass out.
Okay, go.
Alright.
Handle, it'll create a vortex, so go fast.
Or you wanna hold it up while I take off.
Yeah, just create a vortex. Don't fucking go.
Okay.
I said
I don't know if you guys can see me, I only have a minute of video left, but we came back from the beach. We sent the drone out three times. The first two times we had some complications with the fishing line and it didn't really work out. Third time we sent it out, everything worked perfect, but we didn't end up catching anything. And by the time we got back in, the lifeguards were all over us and telling us that we couldn't fly the drone on the beach. So we're gonna try this again, hopefully soon. Don't really know when or where or how, but we are gonna try it again. And we used squid this time as bait, but we're gonna try and use something else. So look forward to seeing another video.